We almost all have tight calves from modern shoes lifting up our heel. This allows us to correct that, and it allows us to squat in a way that builds our legs and our knees, because if you can squat with the elbows above the thighs, now you have a more strict squat for knee health. So as your leg muscle strength drives up, your knee strength goes up with it. You can have your toes on the floor. Some slam boards adjust. But one thing is for sure, this with your heels down and your elbows above would be very hard. It doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with a normal squat like this, but there isn't evidence of people with no heel elevation shoes, heels down with a flat back. What's natural is like this or like this. Those are two natural positions. So now as we start driving up leg strength, if we want to be sending the synovial fluid to the joint to build up the ligament and the tendon, this is now a life changer, and it regresses very low, not only to assisted, if this hurt, which for me it did, I built my ability to get into these positions with one of the exercises you're least likely to ever see in a gym, the ATG split squat, which regresses to even much lower levels than using assistance. So we'll throw a little montage of the ATG split squat regression. Keep in mind, I had to start that split squat at the lowest regression, and now I can hold a basketball, drop into a full squat, and go up and dunk. And I couldn't even dunk or deep squat before that ATG split squat regression to progression to then using a slant board on my squats, which also corrects the other side. This isn't something we do because of lack of ankle mobility. In fact, we have phenomenal ankle mobility. This just allows us to squat in a way that is measurably knee dominant and leg dominant, because we're not there or there.